Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be reviewing, demoing, doing a half face comparisons, and also ultimately deciding whether or not NYX Angel Veil Primer is worth the money and worth all of the hype that it gets, because yes, it gets a lot of hype. In fact, when I research or search on Google, what's the best drugstore primer? This one usually comes up on one of those lists. So I've been curious about it for a long time. It's not a new product, but it's one that's really popular. So I figured I would finally break down and give this a shot. And the reason I'm saying I would finally break down and give it a shot is that it's not the cheapest primer out there, especially for the drugstore world. It's $16. You can get it cheaper, say when Ulta's doing buy one, get one half off on NYX and all that stuff, but like it's usually around $16, so it's not really cheap at all. The claims of this primer are: this incredible formula creates a smooth, uniform canvas that minimizes shine and makes application flawless. Your skin will feel like it has been touched by an angel. Who doesn't want their skin touched by an angel or feel like it's been touched by an angel? I certainly do. All right, with that being said, let's jump into the application and let's see whether or not this primer performs like it says it's going to perform. One thing I will say about the color of the primer as I'm looking at it is the primer is white, which I did not expect. I, for some reason, expected it to be clear. Not that it really matters, but I'm curious to see how it will go on my skin and whether or not it's going to make my skin like white or have that white cast. So I'm going to start applying this on my face. I only have a bit of facial moisturizer on my skin right now. It's oil-free. It's the kind that I use and it doesn't like show through foundation. And I did apply it a couple hours ago, so I think it's like synced in by now. I am starting to produce oil though as well. We'll have to kind of see how everything is doing together. But as I'm applying this primer, it's actually a little bit thicker and stickier than I expected it to be. It's really smooth and silicone-y, that kind of a primer texture feel, but it's a little bit stickier than what I expected it to be as well. It does have a slight white cast, but it's not really noticeable, you know? Like if you have even a darker skin tone, especially when you're applying stuff on top, you're not gonna have any problem with that. Because when I first saw the white color, I'm like, ooh, I don't know. Okay, so it's starting to do what I experienced doing yesterday when I first tested it out on one half of my face. It almost like clumped up a little bit, and it really clumped up yesterday when I tested it out, and I used Super Goop Unseen Sunscreen Primer, which I love, and it kind of is like one of those invisible primers that you apply underneath your makeup and it's not even there kind of a thing, but it protects you from the sun. I applied this primer on top of that one and it clumped up. Like I don't know if it was the primer or the combination of things or what, but it like made my face cakey on one side where this primer was on and the other side was okay. So I'm kind of nervous now to see how it's going to make my skin, but I did not apply that primer today just to see if that was the cause. Right now it's feeling a little bit sticky. It is a thicker formula. It's still like thin and liquidy and easy to spread out, but it does have a little bit of thickness to it, and it's got that silicone-y smooth like slippery texture to it that a lot of primers have, especially ones that come in the tube. Like most primers have that silicone-y texture. I'm not even sure if silicone is in here. It probably is because it does feel silicone-y, and things that are silicone-y probably have silicone in them. Doesn't say it's non-comedogenic, but it does say it's oil-free. So yeah, my skin feels a little bit sticky, a little bit tacky when I touch it, which might be a good thing. Maybe like it somehow helps to create that angel skin appearance. I'm really like hoping this will make my skin look like an angel skin because I really need it. I mean, I have a lot of pores and a lot of issues, and I'm trying to deal with that in the skincare department. Like it's better to not conceal things, not to cover things up, but actually deal with the root cause when it comes to skincare or any other health problem, I think. So if you have acne, it's not a matter of just covering it up, it's a matter of like dealing with whatever is causing you acne. It could be digestion issues, could be whatever. It's kind of like in the meantime thing for me. Like I'm just trying to deal with the texture I have and trying to find primers and whatever else, but I'm also doing things on the health side to see how I can improve my skin from that. I'm basically trying to encourage you to focus on the health and the skincare part of, you know, texture and whatever else you're trying to cover up with this like angel skin primer. And you can also use this primer on top and with like other methods. Let me zoom you guys in to show you what the skin looks like up close and just kind of like the pores and the texture situation. Alright, this is the side with the primer. It did not completely sink into the skin. It does feel like there's something on my skin. Okay, and the other side looks obviously really shiny. This side does not look as shiny. That's because I have oily skin. That might not be the case for you, but I just want to kind of point out that this primer does mattify things a little bit. The pores are, I feel like, more visible, but that could be because of the shine. Shiny things make texture more visible. I don't know if this primer actually filled anything in or if it's just the fact that it mattified things a little bit, but it kind of looks like it's filling in the pores, don't you think? Like, I feel like this primer is filling things quite nicely. I mean, I always have such high hopes for primers before I apply foundation because they all make your skin look so good, and it usually never works. So I'm hoping this one does. For my foundation, I kind of did not know what to use with this primer. I wanted to get a foundation that was like, it performed really well, but not too well that it almost did not need a primer. So I went with Maybelline Superstay Foundation. This is the one I reviewed kind of recently. It works well, but I also feel like if the primer does work, it will show through this foundation as well. And in any case, I'm applying this on just one half of my face, so we'll still have that half face comparison to go with. So hopefully this color matches me as well, because I did apply some fake tan and sometimes I don't know how to guess the color. Okay, so I'm going to begin by applying this foundation on the side without the primer so I don't drag the primer across. Something smells nice. Oh, it's my dry shampoo. I just tried out Kristen S. I hope I'm saying her name right. Kristen S. Dry Shampoo, and it smells really good. It almost smells like a guy scent, like a guy product, but like not too manly where I'm like, I don't feel comfortable wearing this. It's not like my boyfriend's gonna make you smell like another dude. Tick, 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 tick. Like, I don't know if you can hear the sound, but there's definitely like a sticky element to this primer. All right, so this is the half face comparison with the foundation. I mean, is this just my skin that does not take two primers? I feel like not a single primer I've tried with the half face comparison does anything. This primer, it's like, I don't know. Okay, so this side has the primer. This side does not have the primer. No primer. Primer. So I see a little bit of a difference, but not huge. Like, something is there maybe, but it's hard to tell. I was expecting more of a difference between the two sides, but I think I'm seeing some difference. So far, I am gonna apply some powder and the rest of my makeup, and I'm gonna come back and show you the final finished look. But for right now, I think there is a bit of a difference, which is good. Like, it's a good start. I don't think it's a pore minimizing primer because pores are still there and still visible and really not that much minimized. But my skin does look a little bit better on this side, and it's more so that like smaller, less problematic areas look better. I don't think this is tackling like the bigger pores and bigger problem areas for me. I also feel like my foundation went on a little bit cakey on this side as well. It's not cakey yet, but it does look a little bit heavier and a little bit less even than it does on this side. This side looks a lot less cakey and a lot smoother. This side looks maybe a little bit more filled in and a little bit like veiled, but it also looks a little bit cakey at the same time. I'm back with the rest of my makeup all done, and I'm here to give you my final thoughts on this NYX Angel Veil primer and give you a closer look at my skin and what's going on the two sides. I have worn this primer for about 4 hours or so since I first applied it, and I'm not really seeing much difference as far as like the wear of my foundation or my makeup on either side of my face, but I definitely am seeing some difference between the two sides, some good and some bad. So I'm just gonna show you what's going on, tell you what I think about it, and then you can decide whether or not you think this primer is worth a try. This side is the side with the primer. This is the forehead. And then this side is without the primer. A couple of things I want to mention. The first one is I do think it actually does smooth some things out, but not much. Clearly, I still have pores, I still have texture, but I do think that my pores are a little bit less visible right here. And then also the cheek area is still, I think, a little bit better looking, as well as the forehead slightly. I feel like there is a slight difference between this side and this side as far as the pore size. However, what I'm also seeing is that this primer does give me a little bit of congestion and not cakiness necessarily, but it does have that almost cakey look to it. It does look heavy and thick, or it makes my foundation look heavy and thick. It's kind of hard to see on camera, but if I do look in the mirror, I see the difference. So like right here, you can see there is a little bit of texture going on, not like my skin texture, but the makeup texture. And on this side, my makeup looks a lot smoother, right? Like here, just look at the foundation and then look at the foundation on this side right here. You can just see more stuff on your skin. I feel like this essentially makes your makeup look heavier and almost a little bit cakey. I know this primer is really popular and a lot of you guys love it because it has really good reviews, and a lot of people say this is one of the best drugstore primers out there, so that's kind of the reason why I tried it in the first place. But from my personal experience so far, I don't think it's that amazing. Not only does it not do that much, it also has that negative effect on me where it does tend to be like heavy and make my foundation cakey. So I would go ahead and say that this primer is a pass. I am going to be potentially trying out more primers from NYX. I know they have a pore minimizing pore filling primer that I'm curious to test out. I don't know if any of you guys have tried it. I want to know what you think if you have. Again, this is just my experience. I am going to be doing an updated review on this primer in a little while when I'll be doing my full face of NYX, so maybe I'll change my mind, but for right now I don't think it's that good, unfortunately. And if you're using this and loving this yourself, keep on doing that. This is just my review, my experience. The caking is really minimal, but I don't want to apply something that's, for one, not really cheap, two, might clog my pores, three, an extra step, that four will potentially cake my face. So that's my final thoughts on this primer. If you guys use it and love it, then keep on doing that. This is just my experience. Everybody's really different. Everybody's skin is different. Everybody's preferences are different. So that's my opinion, but that doesn't mean that if you love it and use it, you should stop. Thanks so much for watching my video. I hope you guys found this helpful. I've been testing out more makeup, so I will be bringing all of my new finds, good and bad, on my channel over the next couple weeks. So make sure to stay tuned. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.